do you call the blind dinosaur? Do you think he saw us? Hi everyone, Julia here for DNews. Sorry, not sorry, that was kind of lame, but it got us talking about dinosaurs. The prehistoric reptiles fascinate almost all of us at some point. I bet you know a lot about dinosaurs, but let's run down a few of the things you might not know about them. Let's just get this one out of the way first. Humans and dinosaurs never coexisted. The earliest human fossil we know of dates around 2.8 million years ago, whereas the dinosaurs went extinct like 65 million years ago, so yeah. It never happened. But there were little proto-mammals running around with dinosaurs for nearly 150 million years. Some little guys looked like mice and weighed as little as 2 grams, others actually ate dinosaurs. Yeah. Some small species ate dino eggs. No, it didn't cause their extinction. But one study published in the journal Nature described 2 species that dined on dinosaurs. Rapanomammus gigantus and Rapanomammus robustus lived in China about 130 million years ago. Like its name suggests, our gigantus was pretty big for an early mammal, at about 3 feet long. Speaking of big things, some giant pterosaurs have wingspans over 30 feet long. And they aren't dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are terrestrial reptiles, so by definition, pterosaurs, a flying reptile, don't make the cut. They did coexist, but they are separate groups descended from a common ancestor. According to Smithsonian Magazine, Pterosaur is no more a dinosaur than a goldfish is a shark. Oops. And one study published in the journal PLOS ONE found that they didn't use their legs to push off the ground. They used their wings. They would run downhill into a headwind and launch themselves like a pole vaulter into the air. So yeah, don't call them dinosaurs. We know a lot about dinosaurs, but there are some really enigmatic mysteries that remain, like, what did dinosaurs sound like? Unfortunately, soft tissue doesn't fossilize all that well, so we don't have an exact idea of what kind of noises dinosaurs made. Although a recent discovery sheds some light on dino sounds. A recent species of terror bird, described in the Journal of Vertebrate Paleontology, was found with a nearly complete skeleton, including a voice box. The researchers think it used a narrow, low vocalization frequency range to possibly communicate or find prey. Sounds pretty cool and could be the topic of a whole nother episode, and maybe if you were a subscriber, you wouldn't miss that episode. Last but not least, we still don't know what killed the dinosaurs. I mean, yeah, we've narrowed it down pretty close. The KT event happened 65 million years ago when an asteroid struck what is now the Yucatan region of Mexico. But my favorite hypothesis is that a global firestorm flash fried the dinosaurs. I mean, a lot of species were already on their way out when the asteroid hit. One study published in the journal Nature suggests that a series of crazy volcanic eruptions that started 250,000 years before the asteroid hit might have killed a lot of species off. As for that asteroid, a few years ago, a study published in the Journal of Geophysical Research found that when the asteroid hit, it kicked up a lot of dirt into Earth's atmosphere, with as much force as 100 trillion tons of TNT. As the debris rained back down, it could have heated up the upper atmosphere to 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit. It might have also caused a devastating winter-like planet where nothing green could grow, so all the dinosaurs starved over months or years. Or this idea suggests that it kicked off a worldwide firestorm, and the dinosaurs baked to death in a matter of hours, wiping out 80% of all life on Earth, which is a really cool idea. It's so apocalyptical. But versions of this story are over 10 years old. One first appeared in the Bulletin of Geological Society of America in 2004. Since then, some holes have been poked in it. Like one study published in the Journal of Geological Society found that firestorms weren't worldwide. The heat pulses from the impact wouldn't have set nearby plants on fire, but could have done some damage to those further away from the impact site. Obviously, more research is needed. Personally, I kind of like the idea that what killed the dinosaurs still remains a mystery. It's one of the most enduring and frankly fun mysteries in science. It keeps us curious. Scientists learn new stuff about dinosaurs all the time. Sometimes they even relearn old things. Check out this episode as Crystal explains why the name Brontosaurus could be making a comeback.
Everyone's favorite dinosaur that wasn't, Brontosaurus excelsus, thundered onto the scene in 1879 when paleontologist Othniel Charles Marsh published a paper titled Notice of New Jurassic Reptiles.
All right, guys, what is your favorite dino fact? Let us know down in the comments below. While you're there, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.